The story. So, my parents own a souvenir shop in Greece, with the rent being 300 euros a month, but on paper's 100 euros a month. It's something that almost everyone does in Greece. The landlord, the choosing beggar in question. And my parents had an agreement due to COVID. We knew there won't be a lot of tourists, so they agreed whatever money my parents make, they'll give to her. In the summer, there were no tourists. My parents barely made 1,000 euros from the shop. They told the landlord that they won't be able to pay the rent throughout the winter, and she said it was okay, and that she understood how things are. Fast forward to March 2021, my parents receive a letter from her lawyer saying that we weren't paying the rent for no reason, and that if they don't pay the rent for the past 6 months from November to March in 15 days, it'll be taken to court. My parents paid the 600 euros, and about 2 months later, early May, they receive again a letter from her lawyer saying that the rent for these months wasn't paid and it'll be taken to court. We understood that she lied to her lawyer about not getting the money, so my parents are taking her to court because she owes us around 6,000-7,000 of euros. She had asked my parents multiple times for money because she owes a lot of money to the bank. Thank God my parents weren't dumb and signed a written agreement that they'll give her money as long as she returns it. I'd like to add that my parents had the money to pay her throughout the winter, but I was supposed to have an open heart surgery, so they wanted to save some money. In the end, after a lot of tests, I'll not need a heart surgery. Maybe later on in my life in my 50s, but not now. Update, entitled, Witch Trespasses, Assaults, and Yells. Last Thursday, that witch told us we have to be out of the place by Monday, so we gathered 5 people and got our stuff out by Monday at 3 a.m. It took us 5 trucks to get all the stuff my mom cleaned as much as she could. Fast forward to 2 hours ago, 9 a.m., she started screaming that the place wasn't cleaned properly, and the whole village was listening to her yelling. At 9:15, she barged into our restaurant and went to the kitchen, where my mom was, and started screaming at her. After a few seconds, she hit my mom a couple of times before I managed to reach them and threw her into the wall, and a family friend got her out after she hit my mom again with a bottle. Thank God she didn't grab a knife. Police were immediately called. A lawsuit and a restraining order were filed against her. She also caused me distress and sudden high blood pressure, which are extremely dangerous due to my heart conditions, and it can lead me to a heart attack. She is going to pay a lot for all of this. I had just graduated from college, did not do an internship, shame on me, and had no idea what I wanted to do with my life. I was on Indeed.com, job posting site, just throwing up my resume to see what stuck. I was not having much luck finding anything. That was until I received a call from a security company. You know, the company that advertises itself as the largest security company in the world. Anyways, they brought me in for an interview, which was actually disguised as a job offer. Experience now would have seen that as a red flag, but I was green and didn't know any better. For those that don't know, security works like this. Client, I need security. Security company, we can provide guards to you at X plus $25 X as the guards pay. Client, great. It's a horrible business model. But again, I was young and ignorant. In order to protect my anonymity, the client will hereafter be referred to as Center. Who Center was is irrelevant to this story. After several HR hiccups, more red flags, I finally made it to Center to start guarding their facility. I cannot emphasize how good of a job this could have been. I was paid well for the work I was providing, not like the security company, but still well. The job itself was cake. My coworkers were awesome. More on that in a bit. And there was such camaraderie among the other guards. Well, all except one person, the site supervisor. We'll call her Karen because that's what that witch looked like. Unfortunately, because this happened so many years ago, I can't provide as many juicy details for a good suspenseful build-up, but I'll try my best to fill in as many things as I can. I worked with the greatest group of men and women I will probably ever work with. I worked with former Marines, law enforcement, naval ship captains, high-ranking military, pretty much an elite group of boys and girls. I was clearly a boy in their world, but for some reason, they really liked me, motivated me to reach for more. The reality was, they had their careers in service and just wanted something to get them out of the house. Don't get me wrong, they weren't old and decrepit. Most of them were from the north and had already retired out and were receiving a good pension. They kept reiterating it to anyone who would talk to them. The thing was, Karen was just like me in that she had a bad resume, had no experience, much less be qualified to supervise this elite group. Once she realized that, that's when the paranoia began to set in. She had a list, everyone that was on it. Their workplace became a living hell. Not only that this witch chased you off, but if she caught wind of where you were going, she'd actively call your next employer to drag your name through the mud. It was sick. Not only was she toxic as a boss, but she was woefully incompetent. Let me give you a summary of some of the things Karen did. Karen constantly threatened termination, openly admitting to targeting employees and minority employees, especially continuously revised the schedule throughout the week, causing multiple guards to arrive, or sometimes posts uncovered, wielded the schedule as a weapon to punish guards she didn't like, degraded our staff as well as center staff on a routine basis, intimidated guards requesting leave, falsified timesheets, illegally initiated traffic stops on center's employees, disgusting amount of sexual harassment, warned us guards not to speak with center's employees, and went through several mood swings a shift. Yeah, she was a real piece of work. Being located in a southern state, there was no union for us. The best we could do was keep firing emails up the chain of command. When I say we, I mean them. At the time, I didn't have the confidence I do now, and I lurked in the shadows. My thought process was, if these people who are way smarter than me aren't able to affect change, what chance did I have? Karen's actions I listed above were quite routine and were displayed on a daily basis. Slowly but surely, the great men and women I came to know and love would come to my shack and say, "Hey, I just can't do it anymore." It was so sad. I respected these people so much, but they were just cannon fodder in Karen's insane war. When the new employees showed up to replace the ones that left, they would all say deuces as soon as they arrived. One night, I was talking with one of Center's employees because screw anything Karen had to say, and they were laughing because a report had just come out about how my company had a turnover rate of 97.5%. Even though it could have been easy to figure out, I had never thought about it. And that left me shaken. By that point, all the original staff was gone, and I was now a supervisor. That's honestly how it felt like. I knew I was a passenger on the Titanic. How we didn't lose that contract just blows my mind. Not only did my company hate her, but everyone who worked for Center did as well, because she made their lives a living hell by being Karen wannabe cop. I figured if we didn't lose the contract, I would end up on the blacklist eventually and get chased out. However, for all the misery she caused people I respected and sent her, I wasn't about to go into the night quietly. And that's where the revenge begins. Remember that college degree I mentioned earlier? Yeah, it's in communications. It's a stupid degree that I don't recommend anyone getting unless you like barely above minimum wage. But what that degree entailed was lots of research papers, interviewing, etc. I really didn't know how good I was at it until after this plan concluded and used it several times later, different stories for a different day. Now, I understand a lot of people might be judging the way I write this post. There's a huge difference, though. Right now, I'm chilling while I casually type this. The difference is, I wrote a formal piece for a professional setting, not dissimilar to lawyer jargon. I knew what would happen if I went up the chain of command. There's no amount of technical allegations I could throw at the security company because they are siding with the very likely option that I'm just saying nonsense that won't go beyond HR. I had already secured a new job in a different field. Notice already in, so I had nothing to lose at this point. I interviewed all current staff and the former staff I trusted and gathered every single grievance they had against Karen. I still have that list on my desktop, and you read some of the highlights above. They had no idea what I was doing, except he has an idea. I don't recommend anyone doing what I did, but like I said, I was out the door and moving on to a different field, so I didn't care anymore. I'm honestly not entirely sure of the ranking structure that center had. There were so many chiefs and different departments within. I had to trust somebody, though. One boss, who I'll refer to as Bossman from now on, hated Karen with a passion because her nonsense made his life hell. I had to test his loyalty, though. One morning, while Bossman and I were alone, I began a little light interrogation while feeding him intel about the guards' situation being under Karen's thumb. He agreed that the turnover was unacceptable, but he wasn't high enough up the chain to affect any change unless he had some sort of proof. I didn't go into details, but I informed him I had a list and I'd be happy to give it to him. He said absolutely. The problem was that Karen was hella paranoid, would know if I showed up when I wasn't scheduled, and rightfully suspect mutiny was afoot. I told him I'd meet him at 6 a.m. the next day. I went home that night and put the finishing touches on the list. There was one final thing I had to do. This was a guarded facility, and I'd have to get past the guard without raising suspicion or alert Karen I was there. When I got to the gate, I don't know what was coming over me. I lifted up the envelope my letter was in and said, "Mark, obvious fake name, I was never here." He just looked at me, nodded, and let me through. Why? I'll never know. Didn't ask. He had no idea about the list. He hated Karen, too, but he did a lot of talking, so I never shared it with him. I met Bossman, handed him the envelope. We shook hands, and that was that. I was already on the schedule to start my next job that overnight, so I went home to sleep. I never expected anything to come of this because nothing had happened after so many good faith attempts with proof. I just did it so I could walk away with a clean conscience. I went to work that night, turned off my phone, and when I came back to the car to have a smoke, I turned on my phone. My phone began flooding with text messages. I really don't have the full story of what happened. This is what I collected from my ex-coworkers. Apparently, Bossman, with several of the other chiefs, had forced my security company to have an on-site meeting, told them what a piece of trash Karen was, how much of a liability she was, and to remove her from the site permanently. I also heard she was wailing while she was being escorted to her car. Ah, yes, salty tears. Good riddance. So there were about three carts in a parking space across from where I parked in the Walmart parking lot, and I was loading my groceries in the trunk. Lady goes to pull into the space with three carts and stops, honks, waits, honks again, then gets out and shouts at me, "Why won't you just do your job? Get these carts out of the way," as she's moving them violently. I tell her I don't work here, she replied. Couldn't tell, how the hell should I know that? You should have done it anyway. I reply, "You should pucker up on my puckered parts, cause I don't work here, and I didn't put the carts there. Find another spot instead of cursing out a stranger," she replied. "I'm going to talk to management." I reply, "Be my guest." Have never laughed harder than when I drove past the entrance to see the woman standing there with someone who appeared to be a manager pointing angrily at me. The manager just shook her head and gestured something that seemed to tell the Karen to just let it go and leave me alone.